I think Henry just has better anti-wrestling in the sense of his wrestling is going to be sound. He's going to know how to hit a wizard. He's going to know how to keep wrist control. He's going to know how to fight in those positions. And I think I do it just as well, probably better, because I utilize that a lot more in fights. So with that being said, he's going to be explosive. He has really good feints. I know he likes to chop down the legs on guys that move a lot. He's going to have a hard time with the reach. And if he does get inside, we got some presence waiting for him when he does close that gap. So if I was him, I would tread very lightly on how he steps into that fire. I know he thinks that I can't hurt him, and I can't wait to show some of the things we've been working on behind the scenes. You could get a little glimpses of that on my YouTube channel, Funkmaster MMA, so definitely go check that out. And I forgot the other part of your question, but just know I'm going to whoop that kid's ass for Cinco de Mayo, one of my Mexicans that he's disrespected.
What do you think about the size difference? Do you think he'll be surprised once he gets in there and feels your strength and when you guys start grappling?
I think so. I think TJ tried to play the same mind game, saying that my wrestling was D3, his is D1. You can't compete with me. How are you going to take me down? You can't hold me down. My wrestling's way better than his. Now you got another guy saying the same exact thing, regurgitating the same exact stuff, and I'm just like, what does that have to do with the fight? Bro, it's a fight. It's not a wrestling match. We're not going out under the lights to go wrestle in a singlet. We're going out to go punch each other like gladiators. So with that said, I look forward to the challenge, and we'll see how good his wrestling really is. I think he's going to be very surprised how much stronger I am than I look. I know sometimes people look at me and they're very unassuming. I could be very unassuming in what they think that they're seeing. And we've worked with some bigger bodies. I made sure I got some short, compact bodies that are very strong and blocky. And they might not have the best wrestling, but they can give me that strength and that center of gravity, that low center of gravity where I need to get underneath the hips to take them down and to keep them down. And again, like I said, I think we did more than enough good work. Henry needs to win by a finish, like a TKO or a KO. For me, I got multiple ways to win. And I think on May 6th, it's gonna be hashtag long night for Henry.
Lastly for me, do you think in the striking he will look to try and stay on the outside, or do you think he's going to be looking to shoot? Like, where do you think he's going to be looking to go?
I hope he stays on the outside. I'm going to pick his ass apart. I really do think so. I think this might be my first stand-up KO. I would like to get the takedown and then TKO him on the ground, but I think if he tries to strike me on the outside, I get to pick him apart and really display my striking once again, like I did against Pedro Munoz, like I did against Jimmy Rivera, and these are all high-level strikers. I would say better than Henry Cejudo. So if he thinks that he's bringing anything different that I haven't seen, I'm bringing something he hasn't seen yet. I'm bringing the funk, and that's a completely different style, something that's very hard to prepare for. Sometimes I don't even know what I'm going to do in there.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Aljo, over here on your left. You mentioned earlier about why you got into the sport and, you know, see the world and how you've already won and your friends and family along for the ride. Is that something that's in your training or just in daily life? Is that front of mind for you, or is that more back of mind at this point for you in your career?
Still front of mind. Every training camp is very difficult, and after it, you just want to decompress. You know, I haven't drank at all this camp. I normally drink in every training camp. I'm not getting smashed, but like after a hard training session, if I felt like after a few weeks of training, I feel like I'm in really good shape, I'll reward myself with one or two drinks, and that would be like my nightcap to kind of unwind and get ready for the next training session the next day. This camp, because it had the stem cells, I didn't want to kill off the stem cells. I opted not to drink at all. So I'm going to get crazy after this for sure. Going to turn up a bit. We got a couple of after parties in New York City. And I know people were like, oh, you're looking pacified. I'm like, no, I just understand work-life balance. This is work. After that, like when you punch the clock, you get off the clock, you like your happy hour, I like my happy hour. This is just a different way on how I like to do it. So I like to unwind, just like everybody else. I'm no different. I don't think I'm better than anybody else in the sense of how I live my life or the things that I do. I feel like I'm an everyday person, blue collar worker. And fortunately for me, things have worked out where I was able to still become a professional athlete, travel the world, and MMA has afforded me that opportunity to go to places that I never even thought would be possible. Like, I only knew Uniondale. I didn't know Australia. I didn't know the UK. I didn't know any of those places that I've been to. I've traveled to, what, like 15 states already? That's something I never thought I would ever do. You know, we didn't have that type of motivation. So this is just I might sound like a broken record, it might sound cheesy or cliche, but this is legit for me, icing on the cake. So going out there, smashing this guy, and regardless of result, you know, it's in God's hands. Regardless of result, I'm still gonna enjoy my life the way I'm gonna enjoy my life. I look at life glass half full. I think if people start to do that more, you would have a lot more positive experiences. I think that's what it's all about, perspective. Everything is perspective. Losing is, it's a part of life, and I don't really consider losing as learning, but I truly do think we did everything enough, and I'm proud to fuck this guy up really bad. And I can't wait to go out there and do that.
Thank you.
Yeah, just over here. You talked about, obviously, moving up to 145, so I'm just curious on how you think Volkanovski and Yair Rodríguez fight goes.
That's a really intriguing one. I think that's more dangerous for Volkanovski, because if he takes Yair down, he's going to have some trouble on the ground. I know Yair has been ground and pounded before, but that was the younger Yair. This one knows how to fight off of his back, knows how to use his elbows and use his length and his reach. That's a dangerous guy, and the way he kicks. My biggest fear in fighting has always been those guys who kick really fucking hard. Those are the most dangerous guys to fight, because at the end of the day, we see the punches coming. Sometimes a kick comes behind the punch, you never know, and it's like getting hit to the head with a baseball bat. So Yair, you watched that fight with Emmett, it was beautiful violence, attacking the body, southpaw, orthodox, question mark kicks, trying to go for like the wheel kicks and shit like that. That's a dangerous guy. Volkanovski's really good with his feints, he's good with that 1-2, he's got a good overhand, a good cross, good leg kicks. He does a good job of like attacking that inside leg kick and using his feints to really off-center and off-balance people with really good timing. And we show that his grappling defense has gotten better, but Yair is not going to really grapple with him. So it's going to be interesting to see how Volk approaches that fight, because I think that reach advantage, I think that game, that style, the flashy kicks and things like that, the hard kicks, that's going to be very problematic for a guy like Volkanovski. He's going to need to be doing a lot of evasion. I felt like even when he fought Max did better with him when he started to open up with more kicks. When he just primarily boxed with him, made it a boxing match, I thought Volkanovski was more so clearly winning those rounds. So it's a very intriguing fight. I like to see how both those guys prepare for each other and see what that one's going to look like. Follow my YouTube.
Anything else?
Henry actually said he had a better YouTube channel than you.
Yeah, his YouTube is pretty good. See, he likes to tear everybody down. I give the guy credit. He does a good job with certain things, you know? I don't got to shit on the guy. I'm just going to shit on him on May 6th.
Hold on, one more. I saw that you visited Jamaica.
Yes, yeah.
So, do you think there will be like a UFC in Jamaica in the future or something? Or do you think that's quite like far-fetched?
I think I go out there and put on a great show. Myself, Randy Brown, Leon Edwards. I think there's a good high hopes for that. And why wouldn't the UFC want to go to Jamaica? That'd be a good place. Wouldn't you guys like to go to Jamaica and go hang out? It'd be a nice little training vacation. So we'll see. I think I go out there and have a good performance. I think nothing's out of the realm of possibility. You know, I would like to help them get established with like a feeder organization for the Caribbean. We're going to try to work on that after this fight, try to get those conversations going again. That would be something that would be really beneficial for just the island in general. Of Jamaica, you got Barbados, you got all these islands right next door. You could have like something that could be a Caribbean fight championship or something like that. I think that would be pretty dope. King of the Islands, something like that. Easy, guys, hit me up for branding if you need help. And yeah, that's really it. I would love that, though. That would be an honor to have something like that, and I think it would be very monumental in growing the sport in Jamaica.
Peace.
Thank you,
guys.
Stay black, y'all.